how amazing and humbling it is to be up here sharing the stage with Eric, Annie, Mingjum, and these students, right? So my team will tell you National Conference for me is like the best family reunion. It's so many people in this work that I love and respect in one place every year. It's so many people here that have gotten me to this point, right? And are gonna keep pushing me forward. They've challenged me, they've supported me, they've listened, they've mentored, they've told me when I was wrong over and over again, right? I've been blessed to find this crew. I wanna give a big shout out to the Wheels team. I'm gonna look over here when I say this. You all make me a better leader and a better human. And I'm only up here because of our collective work. And I'm gonna give a quick shout out to my wife. I love you. One more shout out to Mr. Silverberg for establishing this way of recognizing leaders and for not rescinding the award when he called and I couldn't speak words to him. So we're gonna play a quick game. It's from Brain Power Wellness and it's called Pinky Thumb. And so here's what we're gonna do. I can get that, there we go. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna hold your two fists up like this. And on one hand, you're gonna extend the pinky and on the other, the thumb. And when I say switch, you're gonna switch at the same time. So the hand that has the thumb out will have the pinky out. And the hand that has the pinky out will have the thumb out. Sounds easy, right? We're gonna switch at the same time though. Ready? Switch. Ooh. Switch. 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 Easy. Easy. So, the beauty of this activity is twofold. One, it gets us all present here in the moment. And two, it gets us laughing at our mistakes. Now, it's easier to do that when those mistakes aren't central to your identity, central to who you are. In EL, we often talk about creating spaces and classrooms where students take risks and make mistakes. But I would argue that as educators, as leaders, we have to create professional cultures where we as staff take risks and make mistakes. We have to stop working so hard to hide our weaknesses and our failures, and instead constantly share them out so that we can learn together. As leaders, we have to model that vulnerability. So I'm gonna share two stories of times when I failed. When I failed to do this thing that I'm telling you matters so much. So picture this. It's June of 2018, and I'm facilitating our instructional leadership team retreat. We're at this big fancy conference room. We have nice leather chairs, just like in our schools, right? And I'm feeling like a boss. Right? So we're reading Robert Keegan's Everyone Culture. We're talking about all the energy we spend hiding our weaknesses and how we should be learning from our failures. As I'm doing this activity together, or as I'm doing this activity myself, I'm realizing that I am terrified of admitting my mistakes to my team. These are the people that I trust the most in the school. So I left that retreat thinking about how to create a culture where we fail forward. How that work starts with me. How I need to stop thinking about being a principal that doesn't make mistakes and instead makes them publicly. Creating a professional culture where we learn publicly proved so important when everything shut down in March of 2020. With everything unprecedented, we had to try, test, and keep failing forward. And we had to celebrate those failures. The spring of 2020 wasn't just about COVID. It was a time of uprising and reckoning with our country's history of racism and anti-black violence. Now, up until that point, we had talked about equity. I had talked about equity. We had often talked about talking about equity. Right? But we hadn't done enough, and I hadn't done enough. So here's story two. Picture this. We have an all-staff Zoom, in June of 2020. Our entire staff, over 100 people. And we had an open space so that we can process together. Now, in my mind, I wanted to show up as a listener. I didn't want my voice to be in front, but instead, my silence meant I didn't show up at all. I realized then that I was performing a role of an equity-driven leader instead of actually leaning into the necessary vulnerability and showing up with my mistakes, my biases, and all. Now, as anyone that has ever tried to break a bad habit knows, you can't just stop doing the thing. You have to replace it with a good habit. So I was in a fellowship at the time where we were learning about the power of strengths, the need to explicitly name and celebrate our individual and collective strengths. I learned there that if we were really going to share our mistakes publicly and learn from them, especially the most intimate weaknesses, those most cherished visions of ourselves that we hold the closest, if we were going to learn there, we needed to also reaffirm and validate the strengths we leverage to grow from our failures. For me, owning and sharing my mistakes felt less threatening when I also owned the fact that I'm a learner and a problem solver. That doesn't make the problems go away, right? It allowed me to own my biases and learn from them. It allowed me to claim my strengths and use them to learn more. Now again, this goes back to our students. The more we want students taking risks and making mistakes, the more we need a professional culture of sharing and celebrating our strengths and failures as leaders, as teachers, and as humans. This gets harder the closer those mistakes are to those most cherished visions of ourselves. But that's where the real learning and growth come. Affirming our individual and collective strengths will better enable us to accomplish more together and to keep failing forward. Now, I've said a lot, but we're gonna return to our initiative to see if we can apply some of these ideas. But before we do, first we're just gonna smile. Right? Even if you're faking it, smiling sends all these great chemicals to your brain, right? So smile with me. Yeah. And then second, we're gonna take two deep breaths. And you take them on your own time, but make sure that your exhale is longer than your inhale. And finally, in your head, I want you to think about an affirmation for yourself. Something that a value you deeply hold dear. And just tell it to yourself now. Okay, two fists up. So I'm out on one, pinky out on the other. I know, I see some people even getting set up like, but we got this, keep smiling through it. And switch. And switch. This group over here is really good. Switch. 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 Yeah, Jonathan. I am so grateful for this crew. Thank you all so much.